Hi guys, CodeTutor here, and my name is Anil Deshpande.
We ended the previous video wondering why activity was causing the memory leak. So in this particular video, we will try to spend more time in understanding the context and what is the missing puzzle here. So let us have a look at the source code of the ContextWrapper class. The constructor of the ContextWrapper just receives the context. It even doesn't try to implement the context. So, which is the object that is actually implementing the context abstract class? Well, the missing piece of the puzzle here is Android provides the implementation of the context implementation. This is another class that is actually a subclass of context. And what ContextWrapper actually does is it simply delegates all the methods to this implementation of context. So, ContextWrapper is just an adapter design pattern delegating all the method calls to the context implementation. Having understood this part, now when the application gets created, Android gives implementation of the context for the application. And since the application is singleton, there can be only one context implementation for application object. And what about activity? Well, activity cannot use context implementation of the application because activities have very specific UI themes, and that is why they extend context theme wrapper class, not context wrapper. And Android once again provides individual context implementation objects to the context theme wrapper classes, and that is why each activity get their own context implementation. So by now it should become very clear that we have one context implementation for the application and each activity have their own context implementation objects. And what about the service? There are few facts about the service we should be very clear about before discussing how many context implementation do they get. Service is not a UI, so service need not worry about the theme, and that is why the service even doesn't extend the context theme wrapper. Actually, it extends context wrapper. And if you recall the behavior of the service, you can have only one instance of a particular kind of service. Once a service is started, you can only bind and unbind from that particular service. So even though an application can have multiple services, but there can be only one single instance of those services. So for all practical purpose, service is a singleton. So when a service gets instantiated, Android provides it with a context implementation, and no matter how many times you bind or unbind to that particular service, there can be only one context implementation per service in an application. So finally, it all boils down to how many contexts do I really have in the application. So the total number of contexts in an application is equal to the number of activities that are there in the application plus the number of services that are there in the application. Finally, one application context. Now with this information at our disposal, let us revisit the question that we had asked, that is, why does activity context leak the memory? And if you recall, this was the code snippet that we were looking at, where we had passed this, that is an activity, as an argument to the singleton object. What was actually happening was, when the activity was in portrait mode, you had one context, and when it was rotated in the landscape mode, the earlier context was still there and another new instance of the activity would get created and a new context implementation would get created. And once again, when the device is rotated to portrait mode, there would be three contexts. When the activity is rotated, there would be four contexts. So there are three contexts which are living beyond their expected lifetime, and there is one activity which is actually visible, and that is the reason why we were leaking the memory when we had passed this to the singleton object. And we were able to solve this by simply using get application context. Does that mean by simply using get application context, I can avoid the memory leak and I can use this everywhere and anywhere? As you would expect, the answer is no. Then where to use which context, and what are the other precautionary ways to avoid the memory leak or context leak? These are all very important, pertinent questions, and I shall answer all of these in the next upcoming videos. Stay tuned.
That brings us to the end of this particular video. Don't forget to like, comment, share the video, and subscribe to the channel. Take care. Bye.